Smell of chemicals hangs in the air above the iron triangle. Some things never change.
The Dream Gallery composer and lyricist Mark Abel on the song Lonnie and soloist Carver Cossey.
Probably the character that's closest to my heart in this cycle is a character called Lonnie, and he lives in Richmond, California, where I also lived for 20 years, which is a predominantly minority city that is directly across the bay from San Francisco, but it's really another world altogether, a place that is looked down upon by just about everybody else in the Bay Area as a spot to avoid. It's too dangerous to venture into this place, and all the kind of cliches and stereotypes about how dangerous ghetto people and African Americans specifically are kind of embodied in Bay Areans regarding Richmond. I see it as a form of scapegoating, and you see this in the media, where the only time you ever hear about Richmond is because some murder has happened somewhere, but they make sure to put it very high on the evening news because it perpetuates the stereotype that everybody has bought into for a long time. And having lived there 20 years, it was disturbing to me just because of the implicit racism and exclusionary thinking that comes from this. But also because there are some wonderful neighborhoods in the city, and it has some wonderful parks. It's located in a wonderful crossroads where you sort of have equal access to places like Berkeley and Marin County. It's really got a lot going for it, but it's had to fight for almost its entire history against being labeled as a place you don't want to go into. And to tell this story, I created Lonnie, who's an elderly African-American guy, probably pushing 80 by now, who was born to parents who came up from the South to work in the Kaiser shipyards in Richmond, which was World War II was the big boom period for Richmond. It's only boom period, really. And there were many thousands of people moved from the South, white and black. And the city went from a population 10,000 to 100,000 in the space of about 2 years. And then after the war, when they didn't need warships anymore, it collapsed almost as rapidly as it was built up during the war. And because there was so much temporary housing, the city doesn't have the infrastructure that a lot of places in the Bay Area have. So you can still venture into lots of neighborhoods where you feel like you're stepping back in time 30, 40, even 50 years. But people live there and people work there. And I always found it just a fascinating place, and people having to just do their damnedest to keep their heads above water. And there's lots of problems with schools, but there's also a resilience to the people there. And the arc of the story of Lonnie goes through about 40 years of Richmond history, and tries to give an older African-American's perspective on all this, which is not necessarily the easiest thing to write as a lyricist, but I think what I wrote was fair, and that was his story that I tried to tell.
Many years ago, Dr. King spoke of bootstraps and expectations. Well, there are still some here who have no boots. Just drive down Barrett far enough, you'll see them. We're no more than fodder for the Channel 2 News. Drive-bys, crack dealers, rapes, and scandals. Richmond is the town everyone loves to hate. From the safety of the living room couch, mind you, but none of them has ever been here.
fifth piece, the piece about Richmond, is sung by Carver Cossey, who's a bass who's been working in the Los Angeles area for a long time. He's sung with many chorales, Pacific Chorale, Master Chorale, the Roger Wagner Chorale. He's also a member of the John Alexander Singers, which is an elite group that's a subgroup of the Pacific Chorale, and soloed with them frequently. He's made pop records. He's done just about everything. And one thing that he hasn't had all that much opportunity to do over his career is to sing an extended song with orchestra like Lonnie is. And it was a lovely experience to do this piece with him. I think he really felt what it was about and gave his all for it, as all seven of these people did.
Mark's Harbor and history, and plenty to be proud of. Ball players, musicians, doctors and workers. We're on our way to church, starting to rain now. Well, nice talking.